We all have a story to tell. We have all had experiences that have negatively influenced us and have produced painful memories that currently plague our minds. These experiences have developed little voices in the corner of our mind that constantly speak negativity, impossibility, messages of fear, doubt, shame, inadequacy, failure, discouragement, and so on and so forth. These experiences have affected our lives so much that every time we take one step forward, the voice is there telling us that we do not belong there and we should step to the rear of the line. Our story becomes cyclical. One step forward, two steps backward. Consider the story of the Samaritan woman, for instance, who Jesus encountered at the well. Jesus entered her life at a point when she was living out an unpleasant pattern of marriage. She had five husbands and still counting. Through her encounter with Jesus, she had the chance to review her life. She must have wondered what kind of pattern is her marital life taking, that she was having repeated divorce over and over again. Why did I come about this evil pattern? Is this how I am going to continue with this cycle? What am I going to do to stop this problem? She must have come over to the well to think over all these things, being a solitary and quiet place. What are evil patterns? Evil patterns are negative traits or genes passed from the progenitor to his offspring. Evil things happening in your family, lineage, in repetitive ways are examples of evil patterns. Rehoboam followed the pattern of Solomon, his father, by marrying many wives and concubines who turned his heart from God. Abraham experienced delay in childbearing. His son Isaac also experienced the same. Jacob and Rachel had child late as well. Abraham deceived Abimelech, King Abimelech. Isaac also deceived King Abimelech. Jacob deceived Isaac. Laban, the uncle of Jacob, deceived him too. Abraham's first son, Ishmael, was rejected. Jacob's first son, Reuben, was also rejected for certain reasons. Coming to our contemporary world, in some families, it is a pattern of premature death, inherited diseases, and sicknesses, no marriage or late marriage, poverty or retrogression, failure at the age of breakthrough, giving birth to children out of holy wedlock, anger, disappointment, frustrations, fruitless effort and labors, and so on and so forth. Whatever your story, God can rewrite it. However long you have been in your situation, God can turn things around in your favor. What are the ways to break from evil patterns? Study your family lineage and ask relevant questions. Is there any repetition of evil occurrences or evil pattern or circumstance or systems in oppression in my family. Whatever you discover, take it as your prayer point. Why? Because whatever stops your father has tendency to stop you. Whatever killed your uncle has probability to kill you. Whatever binds your cousins has power to bind you as well. So, before it kills you, before you are killed, before you are stopped, before you are binded, before you are frustrated, before you are delayed in life, break the powers, break the curses, break the evil covenants behind these cycles of evil patterns using the knowledge of God's word. Another way by which we can deal with evil patterns, if the problem persists, ask for specific instructions. Get specific instructions from God. Seek for counseling from men of God. Get counseling from men, reputable men of God, on what to be done to break the evil pattern in the family. Don't forget that you also need to give your life to Jesus and have genuine encounter with Him. I want you to pray this prayer point. Number one, O Lord, deliver me from evil pattern of stagnancy in my family. Number two, every evil pattern of non-achievement of destiny or purpose in my life, die by fire. Number three, every stronghold of impossibility, failure, and frustration at the verge of breakthrough, be scattered in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray this prayer in the name of Jesus.